Jacob, friendly. Leisler. Who are you, and why is your rebellion so important? Well, according to some reputable sources, Jacob Leisler was born in the village of
Bockenheim,
now a central part of
Frankfurt am Main,
in Germany. After his father's death in 1651, he went out to a military school, only to be employed by the Dutch West India Company as a soldier in New Amsterdam. Around 1660. He wouldn't stick around for long though, as his lucrative fur trade, along with the help of the tobacco trade, would leave him the third wealthiest man in New York at the time. Leisler fancied himself as a man of the people, and had a soft spot for some of the French Huguenots that settled in the Manhattan Island. At the time, the French Huguenots were seeking freedom in New York from religious persecutions by the Catholics in France. At one point, a public tribunal, similar to a trial, has decided that a French Huguenot could pay their ship fees by being sold into slavery. Leisler would do all that he could at that time to prevent it. He even bought the freedom of a widowed mother and son before they could be sold into slavery. Under Thomas Dogen's administration in 1683, Leisler was appointed one of the judges or commissioners of the Court of Admiralty in New York, a justice of the peace for New York City and county, and was also a militia captain. So how does all of this tie into Leisler's rebellion? Well, in 1688, the English Revolution played out in New York, where people of different religious and ethnic backgrounds divided into two factions. It was a classic case of the rich against the poor at the time, where workers, sailors, artisans, and low-income traders would rally against the rich elite and oppressive militants. In 1688, Governor Dogen was succeeded by Lieutenant Governor Francis Nicholson, and in 1689, the military force of the city of New York consisted of a regiment of five companies, with Leisler acting as one of the company captains. Many of the men took a liking to him, and he was the only captain that was sympathetic to the Dutch lower class. Despite what had happened in the revolution in England, many of the Dutch lower class were swayed to protect the power of the Jacobites in office. Governor Sir Edmund Andros had been imprisoned in Boston by the opposition, leading to the Leislerians taking possession, on May 31st of 1689, of Fort James at the southern end of the Manhattan Island. This fort was renamed Fort William, and they swore to hold on to the fort until the arrival of the governor commissioned by the new sovereigns. The streets filled with the cry of Leisler's name until he reluctantly accepted leadership on the report that loyalists to King James II planned to murder their Dutch compatriots. Leisler's authority would slowly spread throughout the region, fighting against Iroquois and English attacks. Leisler would take several actions to spread his authority throughout New York. However, most of them were unsuccessful. Even so, he managed to hold on to Fort William without much adversity. This, of course, would not last long, as Governor Slaughter, yes, that's his real name, arrived in New York in March 19 of 1691. Upon his arrival, he would immediately demand Leisler's surrender. Leisler responded appropriately.
Go and boil your bottom, sons of a silly person! I'll blow my nose at you! Now look here, my good man! I don't want to talk to you no more, you empty-headed animal food trough whopper! I fart in your general direction. Your mother was a hamster, and your father smelt of elderberries.
Is there someone else up there we could talk to?
No. Now go away, or I shall taunt you a second time.
If you do not agree to my commands, then I shall...
Jesus Christ!
Right.
Leisler refused to leave and surrender the fort until Governor Slaughter could verify his identity and had sworn in his counsel. Slaughter had no intention of playing nice with the revolutionaries and arrested Leisler and 9 of his colleagues on the spot. Leisler and gang were sentenced to death after Governor Slaughter found them guilty of murder and treason. Governor Slaughter was supposedly reluctant to sign off on the execution, but the execution itself would suggest that he was not only in favor of the execution, but he was very creative in designing it. The court had sentenced them to be hanged by the neck and, being alive, their bodies be cut down to the earth and their bowels be taken out, and they, being alive, burnt before their faces.
I love democracy. I love the Republic.
Yeah, this was one sick
friend.
Although this horrid display was conducted as a warning to all those planning to rebel against the crown, it would only sow the seeds of dissent for future generations. So ends the tale of Jacob Leisler and his fellow revolutionaries. I hope you learned something about this historic battle,
boy,
and I hope to see you in the next video. Peace!